Hey guys, before watching the video, I would request you to subscribe to my channel by clicking on the subscribe button and hitting the bell icon so that you can get an update whenever I upload my next video. Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So this is a tutorial on how to enable the FPS counter in any game running on an Android device. So we'll be using a free app called Gamebench to enable our FPS counter. You can download this app from the Play Store. It's absolutely free and the link for it will be given in the description. Now let me tell you this, that you don't need to root your device to enable the FPS counter, but we'll be needing a PC to enable the FPS counter as Gamebench requires the PC to activate it. So we'll be connecting our mobile with our PC using the Type-C or micro USB to USB wire, and then we'll be running an app of Gamebench on our PC to activate that service on the mobile. So first of all, let me show you its Play Store page. There are two versions of Gamebench, Gamebench Community Edition and Gamebench Pro version. I'll be using the Gamebench Community Edition. In the Community Edition, we get the FPS overlay and there is no time limit for it. You can use it for as long as you want and it is absolutely free. But you will be needing to create an account when you open this app. And in the Pro version, there is actually performance metrics along with the FPS counter. You'll be getting these performance metrics after the end of each session and you need to play the game for at least 15 minutes. Now the thing is that you can download it from the Play Store, but it requires an license and this app will work for about 30 minutes and this time limit is for 1 month. After 30 minutes the app will stop working, and if you want to extend your time limit then you need to contact them. You can send them an email. Here as you can see that it requires a valid Gamebench account. If you would like to trial this app for your business then you need to sign up here. So this is a different thing, you don't need to use this. We'll be using the free version of Gamebench, that is the Community Edition. This only has the FPS counter and this is what I'm going to show you in this tutorial. So just install this app and open it. Here as you can see guys, it has opened and it is showing all of these apps. I can open any of these apps and it will start showing the FPS counter. It's not necessary that you need to open Android Play Store games only. I use it for emulators as well. For example, Raven PS2 emulator and Dolphin emulator. There are some settings that you can tweak. Let me just show you. It's actually ready to use out of the box, but there are some settings as well. Yeah, here as you can see, FPS overlay is enabled and you can choose the orientation of FPS overlay. I have selected to top center. You can select from any of these. Now the thing is guys, how to activate it? It won't open directly. So if you have installed it for the first time, let me just show you how it will open for you. So guys, for the first time it will ask you to create an account, and after that you will be seeing this screen. It will actually ask you to connect to your PC. Now it's saying that you have rebooted your device. Now the thing is guys, the moment you reboot your device, you need to connect it to the PC and enable that app again. This is something that we need to do again and again. Also, one thing that I have noticed, when I don't use my mobile for a long time, it again shows me this screen. Now the next thing that we need to do is enable the debugging mode on our mobile. Now it's generally same for most of the mobiles. I'll be showing how to enable the debugging mode on Poco phone and OnePlus 7. Now the thing is guys, this debugging mode is generally hidden in the developer options. So for Poco phone, just go to settings first. Now just tap on about phone and you just need to continuously tap on this MIUI version until you see the message that you are a developer, just like this. So guys, here as you can see, it's showing me the message, no need, you are already a developer, as I have already enabled this option. Once it shows that you are a developer, now go back. Now just scroll down. And here as you can see, this is the option additional settings. Just tap on it, scroll down, and this is the option available now, developer options. So just tap on it and just scroll down until you see this option, USB debugging. Here as you can see, I have enabled it. You have to enable it, otherwise the PC application of Gamebench won't detect your mobile. And let me just show you how you can enable the developer options and the USB debugging mode on OnePlus 7 as well. So I'll just close it. Now go to the settings and the process is quite similar. Then we'll be going to about phone. Here as you can see guys, this is the build number. I'll continuously tap on it. Again I'm seeing the same message, no need, you are already a developer. Just keep on tapping on this build number until you see a message that you are a developer. Now go back, tap on system, and here as you can see guys, there's a new option here, developer options. So here as you can see, it is available now. We can also see the RAM usage of OnePlus 7 and there are a lot of other options as well. Just ignore them and just go down until you find the USB debugging mode option. Here as you can see, I have enabled it. So just enable it. And do remember guys, every time you want to launch that Gamebench app on your PC to enable the Gamebench service on your mobile, you need to have this USB debugging mode enabled when your mobile is connected with your PC. Otherwise that Gamebench app on your PC won't launch and consequently the Gamebench app on your mobile will not work. Now that the USB debugging mode of a mobile is enabled, I show you how to launch the Gamebench app on your mobile. So just connect the Type-C or micro USB part of your cable to your mobile device, and then we'll be connecting the USB part of this cable to our PC. Once it's connected to our PC, you don't need to set it to any specific mode like file transfer. Just put it down and let it charge, and we'll open a browser on our PC and write this address in the address bar, get.gamebench.net, and we'll be downloading an app. Next, I'll show you this process on my PC, so let's just go there. Now we just need to open any web browser on our PC. After that, we need to enter the web address shown on Gamebench mobile app, that is get.gamebench.net. So just click on the address bar here and type that web address, get.gamebench.net, and hit enter. So now their site will open, and here, as you can see guys, they have given all the instructions. So first we need to download the Gamebench Android service launcher. Since I am using it on my Windows PC, I click on download here, and now their app will start to download. So just click on save here. Here, as you can see guys, these are the other instructions. On your mobile phone, you will probably see this message as well. So just check on always allow from this computer and then tap on OK. And once we are done with that, just launch the Gamebench launcher.exe file, which we just downloaded, and just do that now. So here, as you can see guys, this is the app, and I'll just open it now. And you'll be seeing this interface, and it is searching for my mobile. And here, as you can see, it has started to launch the service. And after this, you can check on your mobile that it has been done. Once it has activated the Gamebench app on your mobile, it will show this all done, and the same thing will be displayed on your mobile phone app as well. So guys, now you can disconnect your mobile from your PC. Yeah, now that we have launched the Gamebench app on our PC, it has activated the Gamebench app on our mobile. Here, as you can see, all the apps are now showing. I can run any game and it will start showing me that FPS. Here, as you can see, I launched the Asphalt 9 game. And here, as you can see guys, it is showing me the FPS counter. So this is how you can run any game on Android device with the FPS counter enabled. Good thing about this app is that there is no time limit for its usage. You can use it for as long as you want. But do remember guys, whenever you see the message that your device has been rebooted, you need to do this procedure again. And do remember guys, with the community edition, you only get the FPS counter, but if you want to have extra features like processor usage, battery consumption, and also some other performance stats, then you need to use that pro version. So guys, I'll end this tutorial here. I hope you found it useful. If you did, please hit the like button. If you did not, you can hit the dislike button. Please consider subscribing to the channel. Looking forward to such similar content in the near future. Thanks for watching and have a nice day.